Hallelujah, hallelujah. Yeah. We're going to break the chains.
Spirit of thanksgiving.
Yes.
We're thanking you for all of the blessings.
Yes, Lord.
That we have been experiencing.
Yes.
Since day one of our lives.
Yes, Lord.
We thank you, Father, for the shoes you have placed on our feet.
Thank you, Lord.
For the clothes on our back.
Have mercy, Lord.
We thank you for our homes and
thank you.
For our families.
Yes.
Dear Lord, we thank you for our church home.
Yes, Lord.
Father, we thank you because you brought us from a long and mighty
journey. Yeah, that's right.
As we reflect and look back over our lives,
yeah,
we recognize that you got us out of some tough situations.
Yes, Lord.
That's you brought us through some difficult circumstances.
Yeah.
And so we stand here this morning declaring and decreeing,
yeah,
thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for being God and God all by yourself.
That's right. Yes, Lord.
Thank you for the greatest sacrifice that you ever made to us.
Yeah.
And that is through your son, Jesus Christ.
Oh, Jesus. Yes, Lord.
And it is in him that we move and have our being.
Yes, right.
It is in him that we are saved, sanctified, and filled with your Holy Spirit.
Yes, Lord.
So, Father, we come right now to say thank you.
Thank you.
Father, we come this morning with praise on our lips.
Yes, Lord.
With worship in our spirit.
Yes, Lord.
We come to admonish you. We come to lift you up.
Yeah.
We come to speak well of you. We come to make your name great.
Yes.
Because all of the glory, all of the credit will
go
to you.
Yes.
So to God alone be the glory.
Yeah.
Now, the Lord, we do pray that you will give us a word.
Praise the Lord.
Pray now that you will speak to our hearts.
Yes, Lord.
Our minds and our spirits.
Praise the Lord.
Speak to the totality of who we are.
Yeah.
Speak to our existence. Speak
yes,
to our physical, intellectual, and spiritual being.
Yeah.
We need you, Lord.
Need you, Lord.
And we need to hear from you.
Yeah.
It is in Jesus' name we pray.
In Jesus' name.
Come on, put those hands.
Yeah.
Summons your attention.
Yeah.
To the first book of the Hebrew scripture, the first book of the Bible, mm-hmm. Genesis, mm-hmm. chapter 5.
Yeah.
Amen. Verses 21 through verses 27.
Okay. Yes, Lord.
Genesis chapter 5, verses 21 through verses 27.
Yeah.
NIV transliteration of the original text. Beginning in verse 21, you will find these following words as recorded. When Enoch had lived 65 years,
mm-hmm.
he became the father of Methuselah.
That's right.
Now he became the father of Methuselah.
Yeah.
Enoch walked faithfully
uh-huh.
with God 300 years.
Mercy, Lord.
And had other sons and daughters.
Mm-hmm.
Altogether, Enoch lived a total of 365 years.
Uh-huh.
Enoch walked faithfully with God.
Mm-hmm.
Then he was no more.
Uh-huh.
Because God took him away.
Uh-huh.
He didn't die. God just took him.
That's right.
Took him away.
Yeah.
Verse 25 says, when Methuselah
mm-hmm.
had lived 187 years,
mm-hmm.
he became the father mm-hmm. of Lamech.
Yeah.
And Right. He became the father of the man. Methuselah lived 782 years and had other sons and daughters.
Mercy, Lord.
All together, mm-hmm. Methuselah lived a total of 969 years, and then he died.
Mercy, Lord.
I'm going to place demonic emphasis on verse 27. It says, all together, mm-hmm. Methuselah lived a total of 969 years, and then
mercy, Lord.
He died. I want to talk from this subject, the resolve to live.
Yeah.
You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. The resolve to live.
All right.
Look at your neighbor very quickly and say, neighbor, the resolve to live. The recent news of Robin Williams, famed actor and comedian, and not only recent news of Robin Williams, but many pastors and other people's suicidal death was painful for millions of people. Mm-hmm. Not only because they was beloved ones, but because suicide is not a topic in which many people like to address.
All right.
It is definitely a topic that many churches, ministers, ministry leaders, and ministries are afraid to address.
That's right.
This is especially true for the countless numbers of Christians who are still grieving for loved ones or who have struggled with suicidal thoughts themselves.
All right.
However, I believe that the church must at least begin to have beginner's dialogue on this subject. Why? Because when suicide does happen, it embraces in the wake of such national news such as CNN and MSNBC, the regular news, the internet lists up with commentary, critique, point, and counterpoint.
All right.
And it is often difficult to gauge because some of it is helpful, and then on the other hand, some of it is not so helpful.
All right.
Okay. Now, I will submit to you that I am no expert on this matter.
All right.
And I would not pretend to know everything that needs to be said about such a difficult subject as the one we, you and I, are discussing today.
Right. Yeah.
Nevertheless, I thought that it might be helpful to at least initiate the conversation to try to help you and I think theologically and pastorally about this tragic subject that is called suicide.
Right. All right.
So therefore, let me say up front, I also believe that the subject of suicide should be approached sensitively and compassionately.
Yeah.
Let me tell you why. Because you and I must be mature enough to understand that many people will listen to this subject of suicide with different ears.
All right.
For some people, this topic is an interesting theological question.
Yeah.
Why? Because some people want to know what is God's thought process. What does God have to say biblically about suicide?
Come on.
For other people, they're thinking about how to minister effectively when the need arises. So just in case someone in their family or some confidant, some friend or co-worker are having thoughts of suicide, they want to know what to say, when to say, and how to say it. Because oftentimes, church folk don't know what to say.
Yeah.
And they definitely don't know when to say it.
All right.
And they sure don't know how to say it.
All right.
Preach, Pastor Jay. I'm doing the best I can.
Yeah. All right. All right. Yeah.
For other people, the mere mention of suicide summons from within them a pain too deep for words.
Mm-hmm.
In other words, they have a much difficulty in expressing the pain that they often feel.
Yeah.
And so consequently, they need someone to effectively communicate what it is difficult for them to express.
Yeah.
So here it is. Suicide is complicated. Mm-hmm. And it is complicated and it happens for different reasons.
Yeah.
Many psychiatrists believe that many people who commit suicide, which is the act of taking one's own life, are losing a battle against some form or level or some shape of major depression.
Yeah.
What kind of depression? Depression evolved from perhaps bipolar disorder, drug or alcohol use, post-traumatic stress disorder, schizophrenia, or other stressful life issues such as financial or relationship problems.
Yeah.
It is interesting to note that the World Health Organization estimates that approximately 1 million people die each and every year from suicide.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, some people wake up in the morning encompassed with so much pain and despair, intensified to represent everything that is wrong with their lives.
All right.
In other words, they don't see the bright side, they only can see the dark side.
Yeah.
And because they can only see the dark side, because they only can see the pain and the hurt, they're often seeking relief from the dark side.
All right.
The dark side of feeling ashamed, guilty, or like they are a burden to other people. So consequently, they suffer in silence because they don't want nobody to look down on them.
That's right.
They don't want nobody to get tired. You know, people will get tired of talking to you.
Yeah.
People will get tired of hearing and listening to your problems. And so sometimes they will retreat by themselves because they don't want to feel like they are a burden to anyone.
Yeah.
Sometimes they're seeking relief from the dark side because sometimes they feel like a victim. Sometimes you get to the point you feel like your back is against the wall.
All right.
Everybody, everything is against you. And sometimes life can't be like that.
That's right.
Sometimes the devil will attack you from the east and the west, the north and the south. And sometimes your back is against the wall. And you feel like, damn, if I do it, damn, if I don't, my children are acting up, your spouse are acting crazy.
Yeah.
Put food on the tables, clothes on the back, shoes on the feet. Provide a roof over the head to take care of the bills.
Yeah.
So unfortunately, some people are seeking relief.
Yes, Lord.
From the dark side. Hear me now. When people can only see the dark side.
Yeah.
Let me say it one more time. When people can only see the dark side, they begin to do several things. Number one, they begin to have trouble concentrating or thinking clearly.
That's right.
Now the devil is playing tricks in their mind.
Yeah.
That's why you gotta know how to pray even over your head.
That's right.
The people can slow their mind. You can conquer the rest of the body.
Yeah.
And every now and then you gotta do like David saying, and the Lord is in my head of all.
Yeah.
So no cup can run over.
Yeah.
But some people can only see the dark side, they begin to experience a sudden change in behavior. So some people need to be around a lot of people.
Yeah.
Then there are some people who don't want to be around nobody.
That's right.
There are some people who begin to eat too much because they're trying to eat their pain away.
Uh-huh.
And some people try to starve their pain away.
Yeah.
They cannot eat at all. They lose their appetite.
Uh-huh.
Some people begin to sleep all day. They begin to oversleep. And some people don't get enough sleep.
Yeah.
Simply because they can only see the dark side.
Yeah.
Sometimes they can only see the dark side. They begin to lose interest in activities they used to enjoy.
Yeah.
So they don't want to go to the show. They don't want to go to the mall. They
don't
want to go for a walk.
That's right.
They don't want to go nowhere. They want to sit in the house and just be left alone because the activities that they used to enjoy, they no longer get the joy out of those activities anymore.
That's right.
Why? Because they can only see the dark side.
Yeah.
People who can only see the dark side start to pull away from friends. And from family members.
That's right.
They cannot be reached. They never answer the phone.
They
never return the text.
Yeah.
Because they are pulling.
Yeah.
Pulling away.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Some folk even start to talk about them and imagine
what life
would be like without them.
Mercy Lord.
They start to say stuff like, y'all would be okay if I wasn't around.
Mercy Lord.
They even start to get their business and their house in order because they are preparing for life to go on without them.
That's right.
Here's the question that you and I was asked in interrogating this text. Why does this happen?
Yeah.
Why is it that some people can only see the dark side? Why people begin to go through these psychological and emotional behaviors and roller coasters?
Yeah.
Why does this happen? And why would people always go and get help instead of thinking that suicide is an option?
All right. Mercy Lord.
And number one, they believe nothing or no one can perhaps will help them.
That's right. That's right.
Secondly, they do not want to tell anyone that they have problems.
Who
bad people are.
Yeah.
They will get in your business. Come on, talk back to
them.
You know how people are.
That's right.
I mean, when you were talking to them, trying to be transparent, they would get on the hell of my own.
Yeah.
And then they would issue governor's tweets and put your business all across town.
That's right.
Some people think that perhaps asking for help is really a sign of weakness.
You're preaching that.
So they don't ask for no help, but you do know that asking for help is not a sign of weakness.
Come on.
It's a sign of intelligence.
Yeah. Yeah. Come on. That's right.
Lightly.
Why? Yeah.
Because depression is real.
Yeah.
Outside. You know, when a person is depressed, their entire world is disturbed and distressed.
Yeah.
So they feel like that there is nowhere to escape.
Yeah.
And it is this feeling that makes suicide so seductive.
Yeah.
So attractive because it seems to offer the one available escape option. And the church, you and I, teach and preach that suicide is not the only option.
Yeah.
Let me say it one more time.
Yeah.
We got to spread the word. We got to give somebody some good news. That suicide is not the only option. There is another option. Can I tell you what it is? The resolve to live. I know my purpose. But live. I know life can be full of seasons of pain. But live. I know the loved ones will go on to be with the Lord and seem like a person who loves you the most no longer exists. But you've been commissioned and commanded by God to be. I know that divorce, breakups, disclosures, repossessions, and sicknesses and illnesses will happen throughout the course of your life. You must resolve to live. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I'm determined to live. Why? Because there is something about a person when they have a made up mind. When they have a resolve to live. There is something about a person. Something about their inner strength and their courage and their intellect. When they have the desire and the will to live. To live, when you resolve to live, you are motivated to push past your past.
That's right.
You are energized to face your failure. You are encouraged to hang on in there, even when family and friends forsake you and leave you out there hanging all by yourself. When you resolve to live, when you have the courage to live, when you make up in your mind that you have the desire to live, it is then you are revived, refreshed, renewed, and able to tell the devil, like Job said, this morning. Our text presents to us a man who has to resolve to live.
Yeah.
Who is this man, Pastor Jay? This man is Methuselah.
Yeah.
Who was Methuselah? He was a Hebrew patriarch.
Yeah.
I can say so glad to be so, but he was the son of Enoch.
That's right.
Enoch was one who was walking with God in
that's right.
Day.
Yeah.
He and Cat started walking with God and just hanging out with God. Mm-hmm. Yes. He looked back and saw that he was more closer to heaven than he was to earth.
Go!
He was more to heaven.
Come on.
He served faithfully with God.
Yeah.
He's the son of
that's
Enoch.
Right.
He is the father of Lamech.
Uh-huh.
And then he's also known as the grandfather
uh-huh.
of Noah.
Yeah.
It was Noah who preached for over 120 years.
That's right.
That it was going to rain. Right.
Yeah.
That is known about Methuselah.
Uh-huh.
Methuselah did not have an extraordinary life.
Uh-huh.
He wasn't rich like Jay-Z.
Uh-huh.
He wasn't an entertainer like Beyonce.
Uh-huh.
He was not a great innovator
uh-huh.
like Steve Jobs.
All right.
He did not revolutionize the social media world
uh-huh.
like Bill Gates.
Yeah.
He was not a multi-billionaire
uh-huh.
like Warren Buffett.
All right.
But he did have a resolve
come on.
To leave.
Yeah.
Matter of fact, according to Outtakes,
come on.
In verse 27,
yeah.
Methuselah had lived 969 years. There's nothing significant that is recorded
come on.
By Methuselah.
Yeah.
But yet he is also known as the longest lived human being by 830
yeah.
years.
That's right.
Why? Because he lived 969 years. Dr. King.
Come on!
He was not a great philosopher
uh-huh.
like Mahatma Gandhi.
Uh-huh.
He did not become the first president of
uh-huh.
the world like Barack Obama.
Yeah.
He was not significant on that level, but he did have the resolve.
Yeah, that's right.
The resolve.
Yeah.
It's not recorded in our text that
uh-huh.
Methuselah did anything that was great or fantastic
uh-huh.
or he contributed to his society
all
or
right.
his community in any kind or type of way.
Uh-huh.
He was not rich or famous or infamous at
that
time,
right.
but he did have the resolve
that's right.
to live.
Yeah.
He's not known as the father of the faithful like Abraham.
Mm-hmm.
He was not a king like David.
All right.
He did not possess the prophetic anointing of the major
uh-huh.
and the major prophets like
that's
Isaiah,
right.
Jeremiah, Lamentations, Ezekiel, and Daniel,
that's
Jose, Joel, Amos, Obadiah, Jonah, Micah,
that's
Nahum,
right.
Habakkuk, Zephaniah, Haggai, Zechariah, and Malachi. Strong like Samson.
That's
he
right.
didn't build an ark like Noah.
Uh-huh.
He wasn't a great leader like Moses and Joshua.
Uh-huh.
He didn't have a fiery furnace testimony like Meshach, Meshach, and Abednego.
Oh.
He didn't have a mighty thing of purpose like Daniel. He didn't have a gospel reporter like Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John.
Uh-huh.
He wasn't a great preacher like Peter.
Uh-huh.
He wasn't a writer and church planner like the Apostle Paul.
Uh-huh.
And he did not receive revelation like John the Revelator.
Uh-huh.
I'm going in the right time. I don't care what has happened in your life or what you did.
That's right.
God is much greater than what you lost.
Yeah.
God is better than the person who disappoints you.
Yeah.
God is more faithful than the job.
Yeah.
That you didn't get.
That's right.
You hold on to him.
That's right.
Did you hear what I said?
Yeah.
Hold on to him.
Yeah.
And there is some good news.
That's right.
Because even when you can't hold on to him,
He'll hold on to him. Yeah. All right.
You just need to understand that you're going to have the resolve.
Yeah.
To live. I don't care how tough it is.
That's right.
Yes, you might have a body furnished too.
That's all right.
You might have some calls.
That's right.
Bodies too that's going to try to tear up your life.
Yeah.
And God is not looking at what the enemy is doing to you.
That's right.
God is looking at how you are able to function and stand. Despite the adversity,
that's right,
and the attack of the enemy.
Yeah.
Keep your mind calm.
Uh-huh. That's right.
Ask God to protect your mind.
Yeah.
So that he can keep you in perfect peace.
Yeah.
So when you're going through the pain and the turmoil,
that's right,
and the traumatic experiences,
yeah,
folk will be like, man, I would have lost my mind.
Mercy, Lord.
I don't understand what's going on. Uh-huh. Peace.
Yeah.
That's a passion to understand.
Yeah. That's right.
That's why I'm standing here.
Yeah.
I'm going to give you this final word. The Apostle Paul says it like this. When you've done all that you can to stand.
Yeah.
Stand.
Yeah. That's
keep
right.
Keep on standing.
That's right.
Keep on believing.
Yeah. That's
keep
right.
Keep on trusting.
That's right.
And I promise you, hold on.
Hold on.
Hold on.
Yeah.
Season of victory.
Yeah.
It's right around the corner.
You don't know.
So now.
Yes, Lord.
Enjoy life. Make the best of whatever you have.
Yeah.
Live.
That's right.
Don't put off for tomorrow because tomorrow's not promised to you.
That's right.
Stop worrying about so much nonsense.
Yeah.
It don't matter.
That's right.
Just live.
That's right.
Enjoy every moment that you set.
That's right.
Live your life to the fullest. Live.
Yeah.
And watch God work.
That's right.
Give me a God of the angels.
Yes, Lord.
Father, we thank you for this word.
Yes, Lord. We thank you.
We love the way. How the Bible addresses
yes, Lord.
Every situation,
yeah.
Every complication.
Yes, Lord.
It gives us solution.
Yeah.
Then we're able to experience the celebration.
Yes, Lord.
Simply because you have shown and demonstrated to us through the life of Methuselah.
Yeah.
And it's not about what the world calls success.
That's right. Right. That's right.
It's not about material wealth.
That's
material
right. Right. Absolutely.
It's not about what other people think.
Mm-hmm.
It's not about what the Joneses have in their yard.
That's right.
But it's really about our ability.
That's right.
To live.
Yeah. That's right.
To live for you.
Yeah.
To enjoy yeah. the season of life that you blessed us with.
Yes, Lord.
So when life is good, when life is bad.
That's yeah.
Not.
That's right.
Because our resolve
yeah.
is we're going to live.
Yes, Lord.
Hold us.
Yeah.
Lead us and guide us and protect us.
Yes, Lord.
Continue to shield us from hurt, harm, and danger.
Yeah.
Please, Father, in the name
please
of Jesus.
Please, the Lord.
In the name of Jesus. Eliminate, erase, delete,
yeah.
every trick, and every attack on the enemy.
That's right.
On our minds, on our spirits, and even in our hearts.
Yes, Lord.
And I pray that no weapon that's formed against us
yeah.
shall prosper.
Shall prosper.
And it's in Jesus' name we pray.
Jesus' name.
Clap your hands and give God a praise.